Welcome to the Investors Trading Academy Talking Glossary of Financial Terms and Events. Our word of the day is volatility based indicators. Volatility is in finance represented by the standard deviation computed from past prices. It means that the faster the price in the market changes, the higher the volatility of that market. We recognize two kinds of volatility, historical volatility and implied volatility. Historical volatility is volatility that has really been measured and represents real changes in price. Implied volatility is derived from the pricing formula in such a way that we put in the formula the current price of the instrument. It's mostly used for options. It informs us about the volatility that is implied by the option's price for the time of the option's maturity. However, for the computation of indicators used in mainstream technical analysis, historical volatility is used. The purpose of volatility-based indicators is very similar to the purpose of oscillators, to detect imbalances in the market and generate signals that can help us capitalize on these imbalances. These indicators also generate overbought, oversold signals. If the price is rising too fast compared to the historical development, it can easily reach a stage in which the price is no more sustainable. Volatility-based indicators inform us precisely about such situations. A common trait of all volatility-based indicators is that they generate buy and sell signals that are based on the concept of overbought, oversold market, just like in case of oscillators. In case the price crosses above the upper bound of the range, in which it should be present according to the trends in historical data, a sell signal is generated. Conversely, if the price crosses under the lower bound of the range, a buy signal is generated. A significant advantage of this type of indicators is constituted by the fact that they can clearly show that the rise or fall of the price is too steep as compared to previous periods, and hence it is highly probable that it has either to slow down or stop completely. That's why these indicators can complement other technical analysis indicators quite well. On the other hand, these indicators have the disadvantage of being based only on one thing, the price. They don't reflect any other data as opposed to the volume-based indicators, which take into account both the price and the volume traded in the market. It's also possible that in case some extremely good news about companies' fundamentals reaches the market, the price may keep rising in spite of all the signals generated by the volatility-based indicators, as these don't reflect information about fundamentals.